Hello everyone. In this video, I'll be talking on the online teaching learning process at the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Meghnad Shah Institute of Technology, or MSIT, Kolkata. In the digital mode, how can we do effective teaching learning process? So that I am going to tell today. In our department, Mechanical Engineering Department at MSIT, we are following the almost the similar process that I am going to describe now. Since I'll not be able to access the other courses, I can only be access my courses, and that's why I will explain the whole thing through my courses. So LMS, the online teaching of the theoretical courses, the lab courses, the guiding students for their projects, evaluation and training, everything is done on the Google Classroom platform, which is basically the LMS we are using. So let us start with the learning management system, Google Classroom, that we are using. Here you can see that the Google Classroom that we have created for the different courses. And it's not a new for us. From last 3 years, we are in practice. And as you can see, there are many courses for which I have created these classrooms. And it is by the time you can say we are quite used to with this. So it's not new to us. Now let us take one example that in this particular semester, I am taking heat transfer course for the third year mechanical students. Let us go to this particular Google Classroom interface and you will understand that how we manage all the teaching learning process through this platform. Here you can see the different titles and over which there are certain subtitles under that. So first you see that the heat transfer interactive session link. So for the interactive session, we are using the Google Meet, and that interactive session link for whole semester is the same, and that has been communicated to the students and students can see it. Now, next you see the teacher's detail. Here you can see my name and you also see that my website address and the YouTube channel address, they can easily go and they can access. Now you see the important announcement, and you can see before each interactive classes, actually I give them the agenda of that class. Like you can see the 19th, I have taken the last class. It was an oral quiz on lecture on conduction 1 and conduction 2. Okay. So in this way, we actually communicate with the students. Now you see the class progress, that how the class is going on. If a particular student missed a particular class, he can access this class progress. Definitely, here you can see there is a protection. Student cannot edit anything, but they can view it. So here you can see each and every class, what are the contents that has been described in the class is there, and the YouTube link or that corresponding class link, those are also given. Now you see the activity for the heat transfer course. Here you can see I have given one activity for the students, and out of 57 students, that activity they have completed, and 50 students submitted that. I have not yet checked. So after I check those and give them marks, then it will be graded. So here you see that in that activity, it is very important to judge whether the students are learning or not. That's why this activity has been given. And you can see that it is not a single activity given to everyone. You see that all the students' name, and against them, a different problem has been given. And that problem has been taken from a very standard book of heat and mass transfer by Incropera and others. So you can see that each and everyone have to solve that problem, and they have to make a video of that, and they have to explain with the voiceover. So this is what is the whole task of that activity, and I have given one sample activity how to make it so that students can understand. Here a picture has to be given, here the title, here the person who is presenting, then the contents should be like this, then a YouTube video that will describe what is the system, and then what is the objective, problem statement, the schematic diagram, and then the important assumptions, and then finally the analysis, and the most important thing is the comments. And I have also provided them the important links so that they can plot graph or can solve equations, or and also the given the link of the screen recording software. So this was the activity, and I just like to show one of such. Let us take any one, suppose this one, what they have submitted. You see, you will understand that they are also participating in the process. It's not that we are only teaching.
Hello, my name is Abir Mukherjee, and of Airstream, using the principles of heat transfer.
Maybe so, the sound and is this velocity bit low.
Transfer to the air,
but I can hear it.
Drop through the wire is 5.
So this is the way by which they
75
are
degrees Celsius. This is the surface temperature,
the
definitely.
Video here,
but okay, the surface temperature
idea.
Does not change.
And here you can see, I
and
have
that
a scope to
nothing
give
inside
them,
the wire
give
also
marks,
changes.
And then I will return to the
case. So this is a.
Then after activity, you see the course plan. This course plan actually contains a lot of things like PO, the course outcomes, the PO and CO and PO mapping. All those things are there. All those things are there. So the university syllabus, the details of the evaluation process. So beforehand, the students know everything about the course. What is the prerequisites required for that course? Okay, what is the course outcomes? So everything is there, and along with the e-books or the textbooks are also uploaded here, so that students can easily access and read at their home. Now, after that, you'll see the study materials that actually I uploaded in a regular interval, and all these are my video lectures. Those are also available in my YouTube channel. The link of that channel I'll give in the description. You can also go to that channel and see that the contents of the video. So here you can see in this way the study materials are communicated to the students. Now after that, you can see the assignments. Only assignment 0 has been given to them, and that assignment contains 3 problems, and you can see total out of 57 students, only 56 students submitted, and 7 has been graded, 49 I have not yet checked, and 1 student did not submit that assignment. So here you can see after the due date has passed, I have submitted the solution so that student can also see. Here you see all these are faded, that means these are not yet activated, and students only can see those are activated. You can see the quiz are simply taken through the Google form. Here you can see the quiz has been taken, and 55 students actually submitted. Out of them, 53 submitted within due time, and late submission probably these 2, and those 53 are graded, and 2 did not attend for that quiz. So class only has been started from September, that's why we have covered only a portion. The question papers, they can see the model question paper, they can see the university semester papers here, you can see. So all these things are uploaded. Now here you can see they can also see the attendance, that is very, very important. Actually this thing students can view. You can see it is activated. So students can view their attendance in this way. Here the percentage of attendance they can see. They can also see the summary of the attendance in the class. Okay. So every day we actually update the attendance here. This particular page the students cannot view. You can see it is not activated for the students, but we have to upload this each and after every classes, and automatically the portion students can see in their attendance view. So in this way the all the sheets are linked. Now there is a result page. There students will get their internal results. You can see till now I have not actually updated the quiz and the assignment that have already been taken. And after that you can see this, when the slot test will be taken, those will come here. Then phase 1 breakup, phase 2 breakup, and all these things are already prepared, but only we are waiting for those exams. This is the main grade book where we actually upload everything, and from that everything goes to the students' view, what I have just shown you. So here you see the all the assignment marks actually we put. Here you see the all the marks of the slot test and other things. Here only the attendance, based on attendance certain marks you can see out of 5. When other components like quiz, assignments will come, those will be filled up. Here you see the overview. After filling up, you will find that their grades according to this range out of 30, how much they are getting, how many students. So in this form we can, so we can easily track individually also. We can track by, from this drop down we can select a particular person and we can get their results. Okay. Right now it will not be understood because the attendance, the class average attendance and this person attendance is lower than their class average, and that's why only this part is clear, but the other components are not yet started. That is why these are not observable. So after that you can see there is attainment part. This attainment part is also very important for the course attainment, but I can show you this is very important for the, according to the NBA guideline, you follow this for a particular course. Its format is like this, that's what we follow. Here we have to put all these details of the different course outcome, what students are attending, what they are attaining. So all these things are to be put, and finally the attainment will be calculated. Okay, so automatically these things will happen, but it is not yet started because our examination process for this semester is not yet started, and this year and certain things, name and all these things is to be changed by the individual teacher. Now the course feedback, it is very important to take the course feedback. Here I can show you, this was the course for the last year, that means the 1920. It is not updated, that is why it is not activated, and at the end of the course it will be activated only. But for the last year I just want to show you that how it looks like. It's like a Google form, and simple Google form. Through Google form this course feedback is taken, and here you can see the summary that we get out of that form. You will get the kind of question has been asked for the course feedback. It's the course feedback. It is based on the what are the COs they want to attend. So questions are asked in a way that you see that, do you think that you can calculate the thermal resistance of insulation on a steam pipe, through which it will be clear that whether CO1 they have attained or not. So there is a small percentage of marks is there for the CO attainment in the course feedback, so that we can attain through this kind of questions. So course feedback is very very important for each and every course, and everything that I am mentioning can be done through online mode, as you can see. So this is what about the theory paper I have explained. Now coming to the lab, another theory paper I also taking. Let us just not go into that. And here you see the one of the lab. In the lab, what we are doing? Let us see. This is the one of the course, lab course that we are taking for the civil final year. You can see civil, for the civil final year, this course of material testing lab is there. And here you can see I have another co-teacher, Kaushik sir is also there, my co-teacher. And you can see that the Google Meet link is given exactly in a similar way throughout the session. This is the same Google link. Lab reports updated. Only one particular lab has been completed through the online mode, and you can see 31 already submitted their report, 5 yet not submitted out of 36. Student list you will find, because here it is an optional subject. It is not that everyone take this particular course, so that is why the total number of students you can see 36. Here you can see the announcement. So again, similar way, the interactive session announcements are there. Here is the course plan. The detailed course plans are actually given. If I go into it, so detailed course plan is there according to the format. So I'm not going into the detail of that. Now, next, you see the safety rules. That is very, very important for the lab. So the safety rules, this has been uploaded in the classroom. Students will go through that. If they have any queries, they ask it. We also clear this part in the introductory class. And study materials, I just want to show you that in this pandemic situation, it is really very difficult to give them an experience, to give them a feel that how to do the workshop or the labs. This is really a challenging job. But in our college, I can tell you, in our department, I can tell you, we have taken a lot of initiatives so that in online mode also, we can do our lab at the best. Here you can see my co-teacher, I have just mentioned you, Kaushik. He went to the college and gave lecture on the different topics, different experiment, actually did the whole experiment and shoot that particular video. And this is a new experience to him also, but he did it. Here you can see the video that he has done about the lab overview, what are the different
of the
experimental setup we have in that lab.
Actually, testing machine. Through this single
here
machine,
we
will able to
impact testing setup.
Testing machine.
Right here you now, can see the all the setups he is actually
use this.
So
furnace.
After doing that,
okay.
Actually before the starting or in the day of introduction, we have shown them the orientation of the lab, and through that video they can, even after the interactive session, can go through that video and can see that the orientation. Here you can see the impact test demonstration. So Kaushik actually did all these things. Here you can see the introduction of the impact test, that what he has given. I just like to show you that what I have just told you, that it is very difficult to give the lectures without any student at the lab, but he actually did it. As you can see, this is in our college material testing lab. He has explained everything. I think in this way we have reached to our students, and students also given very good feedback. They were very much satisfied with the effort of the from our teachers. So you can understand this kind of effort actually we are giving to in an online mode to make it successful. You can see for the measurement procedure, that is also very, very important. What he has explained.
Now first time.
Okay, so in this way actually we take our labs. and we interact with our students. Definitely we take the oral quiz and other things so that we can understand that they are also following all these things. This is also very, very important thing. Here you can see the CHARP test data that was also updated so that they can prepare their lab manual. Here you can see the different test data, their pictures, those has been communicated. So here you can see the theory video lectures are also there. So this is the way we are communicating with our students about the lab. Now you see the lab manuals are uploaded and students have to complete the table. They have to complete the assignments which are there. I just want to show you that this is what is the lab manual. They have to complete the table. Here you can see the table based on lab data. All this data actually has been provided for this time, which has been done by Kaushik sir. And finally at the end you see the different questions are there. Those are to be written by the students and they have to upload. And you have just seen that already CHARP impact test has been done and students have uploaded. Now coming to the rubrics part, students can see these particular rubrics. If you just you see the individual rubrics, this is actually the marks that is given to the students according to the rubrics. These are the different components of the rubrics, like assessment, behavior, teamwork, data analysis and content presentation and oral presentation. And based on that, marks will be given in all the experiments. Attendance marks will also be added and finally the total marks will be prepared. And this is what is the rubrics, where why out of 4, one person will get 3, 2, 1 or 4. And that explanation has been given. This is what is the rubrics for this particular lab. Here you can see this ME493. Actually the ME493 and the civil final year paper is exactly the same syllabus. It is actually prepared for the mechanical and the same rubrics is used for the civil also. And here you can see the students rubrics part, what students can view. The students can view this one. And the LMS that we have prepared in such a way that students can select their name by this drop down, you can see. And once they have selected this, then in the second page you will find automatically that name will come and his mark will come there. Okay, so I just want to show you once again. Go to name selection, change the name from say Sumit Kumar. And let us see. Let us wait and it will become Sumit Kumar. Okay, let us see Shoham Bagh. Somehow this is not Shoham Bagh. Here you can see that automatically it has become Shoham Bagh and this is the marks of the Shoham Bagh. Okay, so maybe because of the connection problem this was late, but actually you have understood that how the students can see it and they can take a printout of this data. Now I'll show you that after this I will show you the question papers. Here also you can see the different question paper for the previous years. Those are uploaded, different sets has been uploaded, so students will get some idea that what kind of questions are coming. And here you can see in the question also it is very much the COs are maintained, the COs are mentioned in the questions. And you can see the ebook that also has been uploaded. Now coming to the another part, which is the online project guidance, that is also very important. I just show you a third year project paper has been included this year, this semester only, that is PWME 581. I was involved in that paper, so that's why I can show you that how it was conducted in the online mode. Here you can see that about the course, if you go to that, you will see that there are 2 weeks actually given some basic data about the mechatronics like automation and Arduino simulation environment. The second week, the sensors and actuators and their microcontroller programming, those has been discussed. And after that, the whole class has been divided into 6 groups. Each group contains almost 10 students and they have been assigned total 6 projects that you can see. And in each group, 1 project leader has been assigned. And here you can see the study materials for each week. And here you can see all these lectures are given by me. And you can see my YouTube channel also. This is the second lecture. You see each week the project assignments has been allotted, the details of the project assignments. And here you can see this is the solution of assignment 2. This is the project assignment. So solution of project assignment 1 and 2, sorry, this is the assignment. And along with that, there was a quiz assignment also. Okay, similarly for the week 1 also, there was a quiz assignment. So after that, finally, these are the project presentation they have made based on the simulation work they have done through in the online mode. In Tinkercad platform, they have done all this simulation. They have presented it well. I can show you a presentation what they have presented. Here you can see I have not yet given them marks. Here you can see these are the slides what they have made, a line following robot. Anyway, so now you can see that project report submission, they have also submitted their projects. And as I have told you that there are 6 groups, so each group submitted 1 project, only the project leader submitted that. So just show you one of the project report what they have submitted. Here you can see the project report looks like this. They have submitted. Okay, so this is the way they are working. And after that, after these 4 weeks, that means after this 1 month, from September onwards, it was their problem to complete the project, that means complete the prototype. And for that, what I did is that I prepared a Gantt chart, because regularly I was not sitting with them. So I prepared a Gantt chart, you can see, through which I follow their work. Here you can see that there are 6 groups in the 6 tabs. As you can see, there are 6 groups, and this is the group 1. These are the things that they have to write, like basic training, simulation, PPT presentation, cost estimation, project report writing, arrangement of fund, buying the components, and all these things. As you can see, the paper writing, poster making, then prototype video making, project report updating, and finally the PPT updating. Already they have submitted a project report and PPT, but that is not the final. After making the prototype, there should be some changes of the PPT and the project report that is to be done finally. So this was the skip, and you can see that this is the group 1, and he is the project leader. Here you can see, and it is the responsibility of the project leader to maintain this particular sheet where they will mention that how the team members are performing their work, whether they are doing well or not, and accordingly I am going to give them marks based on the comments of the project leader. So this is the way the whole Gantt chart is prepared, and Here you can see that the project leaders are basically updating it, and this particular Gantt chart is only communicated to the project leaders. It is not communicated to every students, and project leaders are controlling this particular status based on their progression. So here you can see this group 1 has done well, only the paper and poster making part is going on, and finally this, and they have already prepared their prototype video making, they have completed, that means so if they have completed, here you can see the prototype submission in the form of a video. I just want to show you, let us consider group 3 also submitted. Let us see what group 3 has done.
Bold
so they made the complete video.
The purchases will be
from the manufacturing, connect assembly, everything you can
right team, and these servo motors and ultrasonic sensors, they're all operated at 5 volts. After proper connections are made, we will requirement.
And here you can see give you an idea that how it was working. So what I want to mention here is that it is very much possible that by guiding the students in the online mode, and they have done a very good job, I must say. Here you can see all these things we are doing in the online mode. Now let us come to the online interactive session, that is very very important. But we prefer to make the YouTube video first and communicate to the students. They will go through those videos, and in the interactive session is basically we set for the doubt clearing classes. So if they find any doubts, then they will ask, and it is the responsibility of the teacher to clear that in the interactive session. We do not prefer to give lectures in the interactive session because there are many situations where connection problems and other things happen. So in that case, they are going to miss that. So that is why we prefer to make the videos and upload it either in the YouTube or some directly upload in the classroom so that they can access. Here, in the interactive session, we go through the live quiz, or we go through the oral quiz. These are the things by which we interact and we clear the doubts. So in interactive session, when it is coming, so definitely the question of chalkboard will come first. And I can tell you that we are using very good softwares like OpenBoard so that we can give them a feel that we are in the classroom. I'm just showing you, these are certain board work that I have done on the heat transfer course. You can see, and you can see the facility of this kind of virtual board, though it's giving an idea that as if you are writing in chalk in the green board, as well as you can import the pictures from the book and others so that the visual effect will also be better. So here you can see these are the different board work that we can also send to the students in the form of a PDF. So now you can see the interactive session is basically done by Google Meet software, and we use the Meet attendance extension so that through a single click we can take the attendance at a particular moment. So it is not that if the 57 students in my class present and I will waste around 10 minutes to take the attendance. So we use this particular extension to take by a single click, we'll get the attendance. Here you can see that in the live quiz, we prefer to take the live quiz during the interactive session in the Google Meet, so that we can understand that everyone is participating, everyone is understanding or not. But these are very, very important thing. Definitely we can take the oral quiz in the interactive session, that is okay, but as well as the live quiz is very, very effective. I'm just showing you the from the how students are getting this live quiz. Can you see my screen? So here you can see one of the live quiz I was prepared in the for the on impact test for the students. And if I start, you see that how students are going to get it. It is not that every students are going get the same questions. The six questions will come randomly to the different students. And here you see the question, and these are the options they have to answer. And at the top you can see the time is running out, and one have to answer by this time. Okay, so this time setting you can do when you are preparing the quiz, and in this way you can interact with the live with the students. And remember that at the same time quiz is running, but each students are not getting the same question. It is randomly coming to the different questions. The six question in a shuffled way is coming to the students, but the total time for the quiz is same, but they are going in a different way. And so this is the interface that students face. Now I just want to show you another class video.
Can you see my screen? Can you see my screen?
Wait, here this is one of the class that I the theory class on the impact test that I have taken. I live during that live class I recorded it, and you can get an idea that how in a Google Meet it looks like.
Can you see my screen?
So
yes sir.
Okay,
so that particular class also I can give after that to the students. Here you can see for creating the own lecture videos, certain things are required for the students, like a webcam may be required, or one can omit that also if no videos are required. Headset is very, very important. Microphone is required. Pin tab is very, very effective for taking the interactive classes on board. And laptop or PC, that is definitely required. And screen recording software, one screen recording software is very, very important. And PPT or some virtual board, that is required. So in the description I have given the link for the my recommended products that I have actually I am using, that you can see here. You can see that one of my latest video that I have shoot with this
objective of this lecture is to make a good instruments
with this tool.
Axial position,
you can see it, can also Now coming to the online evaluation system, this is very, very important. It is not a very easy task to evaluate properly in the online mode. So we are using different kinds of technique by which we can evaluate our students. So first you see the assignments upload link. So definitely the students in the assignment upload link, what we do, the students are distributed, the students are given the assignments, and students do it in their copy. They scan that page and they get the upload link in the classroom, and there they upload. And not only that, from our side also, to give them a real life feeling, we are using this Kami extension, Kami software, that you can see, so that we can annotate properly in that PDF and students can see. Here you can see that particular assignment, sample assignment I'm showing you that I have checked. Here you can see the assumptions should to be written, that has been identified. I have mentioned certain comments. So and students will be able to see. So these will help students to get the same feeling in the online mode. Now you see the limited time Google form quiz assignment, that is very common that we know. I am just showing a common interface. This was taken for a 3 weeks online course on quantitative aptitude logical reasoning. So this was the interface. So anyway, now see the section specific quiz, that is also another very important one, because the same questions to everyone is not a good idea for the online mode quizzing. So what we do here is basically you can see that a drop down menu will come and student will select their roll number, and you see that each and every roll number the question has been divided into three sections, batch A, batch B and batch C, and randomly students are allotted these batches. So when a particular student will answer say batch A questions, and then they will get the submit button and they will submit. That means the three different sets has been actually distributed randomly within the student. So everyone is not going to get the same questions. So this is another way by which we can make it, we can evaluate our students properly. Then the live quiz during interactive session using quizzes, already I have shown you that how we can take the live quiz, but here you see that how we get the evaluation report from the quizzes software or online platform. Here is one of the example I'm just showing you. I have taken this in one of my project class initial training part. Let's see, here you see in the list 2 against each student the accuracy level has been given. Okay, forget about the this score depends on many things, not only the accuracy along with the time and all that, but I will consider the I'll prefer to consider this accuracy part only. And here you can see, since it was a live quiz, you see the variation of the marks. Students can get marks from 0 to 100%, and against each students you are getting this data. So this is very easily from this Excel data you can import in your LMS. So oral quiz and presentation definitely is another way of interacting with the students and evaluate students. Invigilate in the Google Meet, making sure that the camera of the students are on during the limited time exam. That also can be done if you want to take a test, and in it you have to make sure that the students make their camera on, keep their camera on, and they are writing in front of you. You can pin different students and see their position of their copy and how they are writing. So in that way also it is possible to take exam, and after that they will upload in the classroom link. Not only that, we have also conducted online training in last 3-4 months. I can show you, this is one of the training, the first one you see, one of the training we have conducted on mechatronics and advanced abrasive machining process. I was involved in that mechatronics training. Advanced abrasive machining process was taken by Dr. Monish Mukhopadhyay, and you can see these are the results, the toppers list of these two courses, and these two courses was completely done in on an online basis. Here you can see another training that was organized by the Department of Mechanical Engineering, MSIT. It was on the quantitative aptitude and logical reasoning in the month of July, I think, and they were the toppers. Another online training was given on SolidWorks during the same period, I know, but I was not involved, so I do not have the data for that. So I'm just showing this data. We were the institute partner for the ASME conducted IGTI student webinar series on turbo machinery design and future trends. It was conducted in July and we were participating with our fullest. So you can see that in online mode we have communicated in many way with our students and with the society. So finally, what I want to say is that it's a nice experience by which we teach our students, and you can see this particular interface, and this is the way we are communicating with our students during the interactive session. So thank you.